God is good. And all the time. God is good. And all the time. God is good. All the time. He put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good.
Yes, he is.
All the time. Through the darkest night, his light will shine. God is good.
Yes, he is.
God is good. All the time. Light will shine. God is good.
Yes,
God is good all the time.
That's right.
Listen. If you're walking through the valley, there are shadows all around. Do not fear. He will guide you. He will keep you safe and sound. He has promised to never leave you. Lord forsake you, and his word is true. God is good all the time. He put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good all the time. Through the darkest night, his light will shine. God is good. God is good. So unworthy, still for us he chose to die. Filled us with his Holy Spirit, now we can stand and testify that his love is everlasting and his mercy.
Good morning, friends.
Good morning, Father.
Welcome to this morning's celebration. I hope you had a nice night and are bright enough for the morning to receive all the graces and blessings from the Lord. Yesterday was a bad day for us because from yesterday morning there was no power supply. Power supply came only in the morning around about 5:30. But then we were waiting for this time so that our Mass can begin and that we can all as a family join together to praise and thank the Lord who is always good. God is good all the time, my dear friends. Believing and trusting in that, we surrender ourselves and all our family members to the Lord. Lord, heal the land. Heal us. Heal our family members that we be protected always, that we may go about doing good. And all God's people always do good. Believing and trusting that, we begin with our Eucharist. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Yes, my friends. Today's Holy Mass is offered for the well-being and intention of Helen Prakash when the family celebrates her birthday, Mass offered by Pooja and Riya and Prakash. Thanksgiving Mass in honor of Lady Abhilankani by P. Anthony Das and family. Thanksgiving to St. Vincent de Paul, the feast day of our conference. We thank God for all the members of this conference as they celebrate this feast. May all their works, charity, become acceptable to you. Then we have a Thanksgiving Mass offered by Rita and family. Thanksgiving Mass by the Sebastians, Victor, Vincent, David Nason, Matthews, Alvarez, Ashwin Pawar, not forgetting Artin, Lionel, Edward, Jessica, Purchase, Simon, and Jennifer. And thanks to the Sacred Heart offered by Xavier Francis and family when the day is celebrated by them at the enthronement day to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Then we have this Mass also offered by S.A. Benedict, by Maria Benedict and family, for Rosie Saldana, being the first death anniversary, Mass offered by Eugene Saldana and family, Mass offered for Doris by P. Anthony Das, by Sylvester, by Mary Xavier, and by Diana. For the soul of Gladys, Mass offered by the Pinto family. 10th anniversary Mass for Chinnamma Anthony by Josephine Thomas. And we pray for Miss Placidus Swami, Mass offered by Divya Mani, Francis and family. And we pray to the Lord for all those who have asked us to pray for them. May the Lord touch them and heal them. Let us now prepare ourselves to offer the sacrifice of love.
आज का दिव्य वचन बुरे कार्यों के बारे कहने से नहीं चुकता है। यह दोनों धर्मी व्यक्ति के साथ साथ बुरे व्यक्ति के बारे में भी बोलता है। ईश्वर का वचन कहता है कि धर्मी व्यक्ति बुरे काम को आगे बढ़ाने के लिए अपनी धार्मिकता का त्याग न करे। जो ऐसा करता है वह निश्चित रूप से मर जाएगा। इसी प्रकार बुरे व्यक्ति को उसके बुरे कामों को छोड़ने के लिए प्रोत्साहित किया जाता है ताकि वह जीवन प्राप्त करे। क्या हमने बुरे कार्यों को छोड़ने का निश्चय किया है।
तो प्यारे दोस्तों, प्रभु का वचन दिव्य वचन होता है। जो प्रभु का वचन सुनता है, हम यही सोचते हैं कि वो अच्छे कार्य करते रहेगा जीवन भर, और जो बुरे कार्य कर रहे हैं उन सबों के लिए हम प्रार्थना करें कि बुरे कार्यों को छोड़कर प्रभु का मार्ग अपना ले। तो सारे समय के लिए when we were tempted to go on the wrong path, forgetting the good path we were walking on, for all such moments let us call to mind our sins and purify ourselves. We confess together. I confess to Almighty God and to you my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, to my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary of Virgin, all angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Lord in the highest. Glory, glory to God in the highest.
Let us pray. Show favor, O Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gift of your grace, that with fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. पहिले वाचन एझेकिल या पुस्तकातून घेतलेले वाचन. परमेश्वराचे वचन मला याप्रमाणे प्राप्त झाले. तुम्ही म्हणता, प्रभूचा मार्ग न्याय नाही. हे इस्रायल घराण्या, ऐक, माझा मार्ग न्याय नाही काय? तुमचेच मार्ग न्याय नाहीत असे नव्हे काय? कोणी धार्मिक आपली धार्मिकता सोडून दुष्कर्म करतो आणि त्यामुळे मरतो, तर तो आपण केलेल्या दुष्कर्मनेच मरतो. दुर्जन आपण केलेल्या दुष्टाईपणापासून परावृत्त होऊन नीतीने आणि धार्मिकतेने वागेल, तर आपला जीव वाचवेल. तो आपण केलेली सर्व पापे लक्षात आणून वेळेल, तर तो खात्रीने वाचेल, परंतु मरणार नाही. हा प्रभूचा शब्द आहे. देवाचे आभार मानूया. आर रिस्पॉन्स टू द साम, रिमेंबर युअर मर्सी लॉर्ड, टुगेदर. रिमेंबर युअर मर्सी लॉर्ड. Lord, make me know your ways. Lord, teach me your paths. Make me walk in your truth and teach me, for you are God, my Savior. A response. Remember your mercy, Lord. Remember your mercy, Lord, and the love you have shown from of old. Do not remember the sins of my youth. In your love, remember me. Because of your goodness, O Lord. A response. Remember your mercy, Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. If there is any encouragement in Christ, any incentive of love, any participation in the Spirit, any affection and sympathy, complete my joy by being of the same mind, having the same love, being in full accord and one of mind. To one from selfishness or conceit, but in humanity count others better than yourselves. Let each of you look not only to his own interests, but also to the interests of others. Have this in mind among yourselves, which was in Christ Jesus, who thought he was in the form of God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself, taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of men, and being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God has highly exalted and bestowed on him the name which above every name, that the name of Jesus every knee should bow, in the heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Kindly get ready for the gospel acclamation.
You.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the chief priests and the elders of the people, "What do you think? A man had two sons, and he went to the first and said, 'Son, go and work in the vineyard today.' And he answered, 'I will not.' But afterward he repented and went. And he went to the second son and said the same. And he answered, 'I go, sir,' but did not go. Which of the two did the will of his father?" They said, "The first." Jesus said to them, "Truly I say to you, the tax collectors and the harlots go into the kingdom of God before you. For John came to you in the way of righteousness, and you did not believe him. The tax collectors and the harlots believed him. And even when you saw it, you did not afterward relent and believe him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
May the words of the Gospel wipe away our sins.
Amen.
Vachan tera hai Prabhu, जीवन की ज्योति है। विश्व में कहते हैं दो प्रकार के लोग होते हैं। There are two types of people. One the righteous and the other the evil. Now, what happens to the man who is righteous? He leaves his righteousness and goes on the wrong path. He's choosing a wrong way and he deserves to die. But if an evil person chooses to leave behind his evil way and walk the path of righteousness, he will gain life. That is how when John the Baptist came, the righteous were not ready to listen. They chose to walk their own path than to listen to John. For the unrighteous, the tax collectors, the sinners, all of them ran to John, wanted to listen to him and to change their way of life. And these will go to heaven, says the Lord. So, my dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, the people who think they're walking on the right path, let them continue to walk on that path, not turning towards evil path, because that will lead them to destruction. So we ask the Lord this day, asking the Lord that we were wanting to walk that righteous path, may always go about doing good. That is what this pandemic has taught us. Right from day one, we have heard the cry of poor people. Did we sit quiet? No. We found ways and means of reaching out to each one of them. So many people started collecting rations. So many families in the parish were helped. This is the righteous path. Clothes were distributed. We kept the distance that we have to do it even right now. But then our heart was reaching out to every one of them. That the righteousness that you have chosen to be on the righteous path, that is going to lead us to that eternal kingdom. So there are many good things that have happened in this lockdown period because of this pandemic. The pandemic has taught a lot of beautiful things that we should have been doing right through our lives. So something good is coming out of this evil. But let us not give fully into this pandemic. Let us continue to do all the good that we have been taught. And let this period that is still on with us teach us many, many lessons as to how we can live a beautiful, happy life with our families. How we have learned to give space to the other in the family. How we have learned to be sharing in the family. How we have learned to make sacrifices for the other in the family. That is the path of righteousness. We thank the Lord that these days He has helped all of us to be good. Let the goodness that the Lord has given to each one of us today lead us to walk that road. Walk that path that will lead us to Jesus. And may we be counted at the end of time. You know what is going to happen at the end of time? End of time, we know, Jesse, what is going to, you know what is end of time? Yes, end of time, the sheep will be gathered in one place and the goats in the other. And you know what he is going to tell you? Let us be found worthy to be those accepted and be ready and be waiting to listen to those beautiful words. Well done, good and faithful servants. Whatever you did to the other, that you did it to me. So now enter the kingdom of heaven. This Eucharist is going to help us to gain that heaven. So let us remember the good that the Lord has started in you. Let all the good that the Lord has started in you, may the Lord bring it to completion. We shall all now stand and profess our faith in this God who cares for us. I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
Creator of heaven and earth.
I believe in Jesus Christ,
His only Son, our Lord.
He was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He went down to the dead. On the third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of sins, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us now place all our petitions in the hands of our Heavenly Father. Your response to the prayer is,
Lord, help us to do Your will. Together, Lord, help us to do Your will. For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, our Bishop Thomas, the clergy and the religious, that through the ministry of the Word and the sacraments, they may prepare a people fit for God. For this we pray to the Lord. Lord, help us to do your will.
That Christians may do nothing from selfishness, but humility may consider others better than themselves. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, help us to do your will.
That the spirit with which the early Christians have lived their lives, when the needs of every person has been taken care of by the community, may return to our own parish communities. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, help us to do your will. Ab hum log apne aap ke liye, apne parivar ke liye, प्रभु से मांग ले, वो सब कुछ देने के लिए तैयार है। Yes, Heavenly Father, trusting that you're going to answer our prayers, we commit our families and all the sick members to you, that you in your goodness may bless us and grant us all good health. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and good of all His holy church.
Amen. Lord, look upon the offering of your church, O Lord, and she makes her gifts to you, and grant that when conceived by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son, you created the human race, so also through him, with great goodness, you formed it anew. And so, it is right that all creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore, we too extol with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, the gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them that they do fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink of it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, Lord Jesus, until you come, until you come, until you come in glory, until you come, until you come, until you come in glory.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Thomas our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Bring them and all the departed into the light of your face. Have mercy on all of us who are gathered here this morning. Make us worthy to share eternal life with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. May we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Krista
the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our day, that with the help of your mercy, we may be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Amen. Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above everything, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart as though you were already come. I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Allow me not to be separated from you. Jesus, my good, my sweet and only love, inflame this heart of mine that it may be always on fire for you.
Prayer for protection against coronavirus. O God, in this time of the coronavirus, we turn to you in trust and hope. You are ever full of mercy, compassion and love towards us. We ask you, loving Father, to be merciful to us and in your divine power, take away from all over the world this grievous pandemic of coronavirus. Inspire all authorities to take effective measures to contain the disease. Help us to be alert and vigilant against coronavirus and to follow all guidelines and directives. You redeemed and saved us through the suffering and resurrection of Jesus. Help us not be discouraged, but to believe and hope that you will bring good out of this evil. Father, let your victory and glory shine through this deadly disease, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Communion and defense. Behold, I stand at the door and knock, saith the Lord. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door to me, I will enter his house and dine with him and with his family. Let us pray. Graciously we present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to the newness of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you all and remain with your loved ones forever.
Amen.
So, dear friends, go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary,
and she conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death. Amen.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it unto me according to your word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death. Amen.
And the Word was made flesh,
and dwelt amongst us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that you made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray.
For God receives you, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we in the incarnation of Christ your Son, was made known by the message of an angel, made by his passion and cross, be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. May the divine assistance remain always with us.
And may the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.
By the
Yes, dear friends, thank you for joining us this Eucharist. But see that today, all the members of your family take part in the Eucharistic celebration, well dressed. Sunday, have a good breakfast, a good lunch if you can make one. But today is the Lord's Day, and we are already in the 26th Sunday of the year. Do you know how many times you have reached out to your home? How many Masses you have celebrated?
153rd Mass.
Today is the 153rd Mass that we have been able to pray with your families. Did anything change in your family? Or it has been the same? Jaisa pehla tha, abhi hai, ant tak rahega. Every day we have to change. Every Eucharistic celebration, Jesus comes to me and I have to become more and more like Him. He has to change our lives. Be always righteous people. Don't think about the evil ones. Now coming down to ourselves, this Tuesday, we celebrate the great feast of the archangels. You remember the archangels? What are their names? Yes, that is why the archangels are hidden ones. We don't see them, but they are always guiding you, the archangels. Yes, I know, I remember. I hope you also remember.
Yes,
you better tell your children the name. Okay, that will be on Tuesday. Archangel Michael, Gabriel and Raphael. Some of the names you have got in the parish. Tuesday, the feast of Saint Jerome. Thursday, the feast of St. Teresa or the Child Jesus. And Friday, first Friday of the month, devotion to the Sacred Heart. And then the feast of the Guardian Angel. See that all your children are present for Mass on that day. There will be a special blessing for all our children. And you know what happens in the month of October. October is the month of the Rosary. We are not advised to go house to house. Privacy has to be taken care of. Do not barge into another's house with your family. But pray the Rosary every day. And this year pray that this pandemic may be destroyed. Because Mother Mary has said many a time, say the Rosary, the war will end. Say the Rosary, that sickness will go. So let us say the Rosary this year, that this pandemic may go. Well, let us pray for each other to remain strong and healthy. May the team prays for you. You also pray for the team and pray for all those who are sick and pray for all those who are in need of your help. God bless you all. Have a wonderful week. God bless you.